Your motorcycle and the maintenance of your motorcycle, aka bike parts, are about to get more expensive for no real reason, whether you live in Europe or the US. Now, I don't usually like to do political shows and we'll steer clear of that as much as we can here, but this is the real reason the prices are going up. Stick around. Get your motorbike news in a pleasant way. Hit that subscribe button and turn on your notifications so you don't miss the next episode. This all started back in 2004 when the US got their panties in a knot and complained to the World Trade Organization that Europe was helping Airbus with grants, loans, and forgiving some of their debt, and this was very unfair to their local company, Boeing. Boeing, which in turn was also subsidized by the US in pretty much the same way as Airbus was by Europe. So then Europe got their panties in a bunch and complained to the same World Trade Organization that the US was doing the same thing, but with Boeing. And as two wrongs don't make a right, the WTO has been sitting on this for about 15 years now, doing nothing. Now, the current Trump administration has decided this April that it will start a trade war with Europe by imposing tariffs on goods coming from Europe this year. While this seems childish and stupid, it definitely is a reality in the mind of politicians. The list of tariffs, read stealing, is very long, and apart from knives and seafood, it unfortunately also includes motorcycles. Fortunately, only motorcycles with a capacity between 500 and 700 cc's are going to get more expensive. Unfortunately, motorcycle parts are also listed as getting more expensive, with brakes, gearboxes, wheels, and worryingly, a general parts and accessories of motorcycles being part of the list. Now, this is not set in stone yet, but it may as well be. Europe hasn't been a good little angel either, and last year added their own trade tariffs to bikes over 500 cc's coming from the US as a response to a previous tariff increase by Trump on steel and aluminium coming from Europe. Having a trade war where each party arbitrarily increases taxes is only detrimental to the citizens. Trade wars only work if one of the parties has a resource that the other one doesn't, and not the other way around as well, like raw materials. And at the end of the day, the definition of a trade war is bullying. But this time, the customers are the ones actually getting punched, not the actual lawmakers. If someone living in the US wants to buy a BMW bike, for example, they will pay more for it, and that extra money is not going to the dealer or to BMW. It's artificially inflated to go to the government. The same thing happens over the pond when a European citizen wants to buy a Harley. That extra money they pay goes to their government, not to the guys directly involved in providing the customer with the bike. European politicians say they are ready for discussions with the US, and the last thing they want is a tit-for-tat war. Then again, they are politicians. We'll see in time how this develops. Hopefully it will all die down, but maybe now is the time to actually get a bike at the right price. Blind spot detection has finally crossed the road and made it to motorcycles. Now, I really hate being negative Nelly on this channel. I really only like positive, fun stuff, like flamingos. But why has it taken this long for something so simple and of such great safety importance to be added to motorcycling? This GS behind me costs a hell of a lot of money anywhere in the world and has magic-like technology on it, like lean-sensitive ABS. But something as simple as letting you know when a car is in your blind spot clearly didn't make the cut for BMW. And I'm not just picking on BMW here. All manufacturers are guilty of just incremental, small innovation, but high pricing. $400, that's how much Taiwanese-based company Senzar is charging for their plug-and-play blind spot monitoring system. Virtually compatible with any motorbike, I cannot but think this option would be somewhere close to $100 if available on a dealer's optional catalog. But it's not. A third party has to get involved and make it for us to Frankenstein on our bikes. The system uses two radar sensors mounted on the license plate holder to light up indicators that are placed on the bike's mirror. All standard stuff until now. Senzar has gone one step further, however, and placed a haptic vibration unit under the bike's seat, which will vibrate strong enough to be felt even through your motorcycle gear when there is a vehicle in your blind spot. The indicators on the mirror will also start flashing if you try and change lanes when there is an object detected in the blind spot. Now, there is no way this should replace your trusted shoulder check, but it's just an extra layer of protection that would be very welcome on any motorcycle. Let us know in the comments if this would be something useful to you, or if motorcycles should be left without this extra crutch that would probably replace the shoulder check for a lot of riders. Well, that's the show, everybody. Give it a big thumbs up if you loved it, a smaller thumbs up if you just liked it, and consider subscribing or becoming one of our patrons to help us make more of these videos. Cheers, and I'll see you on the next one.